everybody. This morning I filmed a Get Ready With Me. I was about to say a quick Get Ready With Me, but by no means was it quick. I did have a lot of people last week comment and say how much they liked the eye look that I had created. I had created it a number of days using a new color to me, and so I wanted to take this opportunity this morning and film my Get Ready With Me and how I did that eye look. So if you like something like this and you're curious as to how I achieved this look and the products that I used, then stay tuned right after the introduction. We are going to start with a bare naked face and end up like this. And hopefully this looks good. During the introduction, take a second and subscribe if you aren't already a subscriber. And please give this video a thumbs up if you like this kind of video. And hit that share button too, because that really helps any of us on here, YouTubers making videos, to be found with YouTube's algorithms. It's important that the subscribe, like, and share. It all matters, you know, it all matters, and I would appreciate it if you would take just a few seconds and do that. And right after this introduction, we're going to get started with, like I said, that bare naked face. So I will see you in 30 seconds. Sunscreen all over my face, and I've done that. Now I'm going to go ahead and get these things curled. I've seen my videos where I'm curling my eyes and it looks kind of gross. Maybe that's why people don't curl them on camera, but I really want you to see everything that's going on. No holds barred, and this is what happens. This is how I like to start, so I can see what I'm working with and judge whether or not I want to do a full face or, you know, what have you. I am going to get out a couple of my baby wipes and have them handy. Then I'm going to find my favorite brush. And I should probably get more of this brush since it is my favorite brush. And it is the Morphe I don't know, it just looks like a little paintbrush. I like that one, and I like the one by Bare Essentials, so I'm just assuming probably any of them that look like a paintbrush that I could probably get at a craft store. So maybe I'm going to go to the craft store later and look around at their brushes. The first thing I'm going to do then is take this Bare Essentials brush into my Painterly Paint Pot. How do I want to do this? I need a little bit of brightener under here, but I'm going to go in with that last. I'm going to go in now with my Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation in Soft Beige. Go in with a little bit of this highlighter now. I'm sure everybody uses this or has tried it, the Instant Age Rewind by Maybelline. I didn't get was my Maybelline powder, so excuse me. Don't all of the drawers squeak now. All of them. Pula bronzer in. The only one that I have is not even sure what it's called, but again, it might say it under the little tab that says peel here. If you have a question about it, I would be happy to answer it, but I'm not going to bother peeling that right now. I said before, I love this little tiny brush, so I'm really happy with that. I'm not even going to tap it in there right now. I'm just going to go down the sides. Because actually, I think there's some residue from the other day when I used it. Not getting the nose job, I'm just altering it a little bit. I will tap it in now. And I tap it just ever so slightly on my little, just like everybody else does to. So at the top of my ear, I'm coming just. In a little tiny pie-shaped wedge. So it's going this way and then this way. So I'm coming from the top of my ear to here. And I'm not coming any further than my eye. See that? Just a little something. Now I'm going in with the Fit Me powder in Fair, and I'm going to put that underneath with, where is my soft brush? I think I will go in with this Real Techniques that says something on it. It says expert face brush. So if I'm not an expert, this will make me an expert. So I take a little bit of the powder. Right underneath. That was the reverse contouring I said I was talking about. I know you see Nikki tutorials do it. Then I'm going to take, I feel like I have to clean up as I go, but then I want a softer brush to just dust it. And blur those lines between the two. I need to put some lipstick on to see where I am headed in this direction. So I have my lovely Huda liner from my dear friend, you know who, Sherry A. Maybe that's what I'll ask for my birthday. Not, I don't want like giant lips, but what I do want is, I've done this sometimes when I get mad and I have a couple of lines here that I can't get rid of. I don't know if it's sleeping on my side too, you know, my face gets smushed a certain way for, you know, even if I don't sleep at night, I'm sure there's an hour where I'm sleeping and it gets smushed that way, and so I feel like that's just the way that it is staying. My grandmother always said, you keep your face like that, it's gonna freeze like that. I think she was onto something. Grammy. All right, let's get some lipstick on, and this tube is a mess, but it's a beautiful mess. It is, okay, it's a gorgeous color. So I have this brush. I need to get a little paint, or a little palette, so that I can fill it up with the lipsticks that are almost done, that I like. Okay, now. We will wait before we put on the lip gloss because that can be a little bit sticky. Let's go in with, see, I am in no particular order. Let's go in with the eyeshadows now, and this was the new one that everybody gave me great compliments when I wore this last week, and I really do love it. It is the Rose in the Air Wet and Wild. It opens on the side, because how many times have I tried to open it on the top? It's difficult to open, but that being said, I still think it's pretty. We'll go in with, ouch, I'm sitting funny and it hurt my leg fell asleep. What am I going to go in with? I have this brush from Could be Wet n Wild. No, it's Elf. And I'm going to go in with the lightest one all over the place. Just all over. That's my base color. Now I'm going to keep the same brush because it was the lightest color, and I'm going to go in. No. Yes, I am. I'm going to keep the same brush, and I'm going to go into that really pretty pink that I love so much. Okay, that one's curving up a little bit more. This one seems to droop down a little bit, right? Do you see that? One of the sisters of the Chapman sisters from Pixie Wu said she likes to take her color all the way up to her brow, but I kind of like that too. I like to go up a little bit higher than and that one still feels a little droopy, so I'm really not pulling it down. But I am brushing it up. Let's go into off so that it doesn't same brush into the orange one that is right here. And I like the fact that there's no mirror on it. I'm not taking this out to dinner with me and putting makeup on at the table. So I don't need a mirror like that. I have some of that on my brush. Now I'm going to go in just a little from where I was. It off again, and that's, I think I'm going to have to pick up another brush, because that is getting a little bit dirty now. So now I'm going to go in with the transition color on this side, the one that is a little more taupe, and go right next to it. Then our fluffy brush with that transition color again, and my light just went out. Sorry. I'm going to start in here. That is going all the way up to my eyebrow. Let's see how we can tidy that one up. These Wet n Wild shadows are really pigmented. I'm gonna go in, what do I want to go in with now? I really like that pink. This I think needs more pink. Look at me tugging on my eye now. Get a little crazy and you screw it all up. Pink again, literally that much. That's so little amount. Let's go to this one. This one is Jessie's Girl, and I'm going to use that bottom hot pink, second one in. Now let's go in with one that is a little bit less pink and put that in the spotlight area, center of our face, so we want the brightness in the center of our eye. All right, now I'm just going to take that fluffy brush again into this matte transition again that I used before right here and go over everything with a final kind of blend. Very lightly. Okay, let's slap on some brows, and I like my brow gel, so let me grab that. It's just easier, you know. It's Giordana. I think it's Giordana. Made in Italy, Giordana. Yep. Eyeliner, so. Am I? Because I can't see that far. I don't think I am. I don't think I am. Now, you know I curled my lashes, so let's put this primer on. And as we're sitting here, my hair is drying. I started out with wet hair. And for as thick as it is, if I let it down like this, it dries pretty quick. And I don't have to do anything with it. I have a lot of people comment on my hair and how it gets, how do I get it this long? What am I taking? What do I do with it and such? So that will be a video in itself coming up in the near future. My tips and tricks, what I do, suggestions, and the like to just give you some ideas if you're struggling with hair. Believe me, I was struggling at one point, and by the grace of God, I found some things that really worked for me, and so that's what I've been doing. I think I take more time with the primer now than I do with the mascara. All right, while that's drying, let's put on my blush. And this, I really like this blush as well. This one is by BH Cosmetics. I got this at Ulta, and it's a beautiful pinky with the coral. Thank goodness my mirror is dirty because I just think it's really pretty. And where did my blush brush go? I know I have a lot of brushes in here, but I tend to always reach for the same one over and over and over and over. So, not doing where I did other stuff. I want this up here so I look flushed and happy. Go back with this one that we buffed everything with. Kind of tie it all in together. Kind of one of the ways I clean my brush. I just go around the rest of the head. And pull it all together. Now my brush doesn't have much product on it because I put it all over my face. Okay, now the primer should be done, and I'm going in with the Lash Domination. Who's this by? I don't know who it's by. Bare Minerals. I don't know where I got this, but I really did like it. No smoke and mirrors. That's what I want. You look happy. Do I want to put some mascara on the bottom? No, I really don't. I'm going to put a little bit of my Yves Saint Laurent Mon Paris on, because that just makes me happy. Alright, now we're going to put a little bit of, this was the last thing, oh, this was in my drawer and I hadn't been using it. It is the Glassy Gloss by Wet n Wild in the color, I don't know if it has a color on it, the lip gel. Does it? Glass Confusion 311A. And so it's in a little tube like this, and I just don't think that I liked it in the little tube. But if you take it and squeeze a little bit out onto one of these brushes again, and just get it where you want it, it's great. So, I'll see you in my next video. It'll probably be a much shorter one, but I did want to have this up there so you could see from start to finish what's going on.